It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
It's the college football in the South for many is bigger than significant family events. Birthdays are celebrated at games as friends will be present. Weddings are planned around football schedules. Tailgating in the South holds as many traditions as a lavish wedding. Sports Illustrated ranked the University of Mississippi's Grove as the number one tailgating spot in the nation, noting there's no more beautiful spot to tailgate, nor one richer in traditions. It has been the site of pregame picnicking for half a century. The green lawn of the Grove under the canopy of trees is covered each Saturday with tents, custom decorations, floral arrangements, and chandeliers all awash in Southern hospitality. Tailgating is part of one's upbringing in Mississippi, binding graduates to a weekly homecoming. In a place known for tailgating, what would it take to throw the largest tailgate party in Mississippi?
You know, everywhere I go, people say something about it. I walk around the square and people are always asking me about it. I'm at lunch in Houston and people ask me about it. And I was at the BBVA Compass Bowl and Leslie Hines came up to me and said, that was one of the most special nights I'd ever had. I was shocked at how big it turned out. I think I thought I was just gonna have this pretty good sized party, but never did I think it was gonna turn into what it turned into and the amount and scope of people that showed up.
When I heard Blake was gonna put on a tailgate party, I was really excited because Blake was somewhat of the P.T. Barnum of my era, kind of the Bill Veeck, Robert Ripley showman that he was in college and he pretty much still is today.
He told me it was going to be big, but he didn't really tell me a lot of detail. So when I got there, I was really pretty amazed. In fact, I thought the most amazing thing was to see the band and the cheerleaders right here in this space. It was just incredible.
I don't think people really believed me. They were like, you're gonna do what? You're gonna recreate the Hoka, the gin, and the warehouse, which were all the favorite places we went and hung out when I was in college. And I said, hell yeah, I'm gonna do that. What do you think?
I met Blake when he was in undergraduate school here, and he sometimes would spend more time in the Hoka kitchen than I did. Well, you know, he's from Texas, you know, and I know everyone talks that big talk in Texas, but dang if he didn't deliver. He really came through with one of the finest parties this town's ever known about, ever heard about, ever participated in. And you know, things may be big in Texas, but in Mississippi, things are friendly and nice. And people have so much fun socializing here, and he made sure that that happened.
Blake is a year younger than I am, and we were interested in rushing Blake, of course, until we met him. And then we realized that we were not interested in him at all. And he ended up pledging another fraternity. I'm being somewhat facetious. He did get an SA bid.
We had these Tuesday night rush parties at the fraternity houses every week during the summer to entertain the incoming freshmen. And our parties ended up being pretty famous because Blake went out in town and found the best DJ he could find, a guy named the Sunshine Kid, who people in Oxford still know. And we ended up having just hundreds and hundreds of people at every Tuesday night party. I was sitting on the back deck one night during the party, and this older man walks up, and you know, when I say older, he was in his 30s probably, but he walked up and asked me, he said, who's throwing this party? I said, well, it's a fraternity party, it's the Sigma Chi party. And he goes, no, I mean, who would I talk to about, you know, how they pulled it off? Who planned this party? And I said, oh, you're looking for Blake Tartt. I said, and I asked the man who he was, and he told me his name, and said he's with Coors Beer. And I said, great, y'all are finally getting over the river. Can't wait to have one. And he went over to talk to Blake, and as the story goes from there, he hired Blake to be the Coors campus rep. because really, I think everything had to do with that party.
The people that come to school here, it's a happy group. This was at a golden time, and it just really showed. It radiated. It was really something special.
I had a reputation about throwing parties back in the 80s, and my parties were somewhat notorious. Every pledge trainer at the Sigma Chi house hated me. And I threw these crazy parties. I built go-go cages, recreated Animal House. And so I guess you would say I had a reputation for parties.
Well, the mayor of Oxford came and told us that we couldn't have outdoor amplified music. And so the whole part of our party was to create the Grove out here and have the bands and people dance outside. So now we've had to change all of that. So it's just a minor slip up, but we're gonna do it and we're gonna make it work one way or the other.
Let's just talk this out before we make the decision.
No, we have okay. Yes. We have it here. Perfect. Tyler and I can roll it in.
Perfect.
40 minutes.
Okay, well then they got to start moving this equipment over and we'll just do it and we'll do it in here. All right, let's go.
You got to build your house on firm foundation. Got to build your house upon solid ground. You got to build your house on a firm foundation. Got to build your house upon solid. You got to stay grounded. Don't wanna get electrocuted. You got to stay grounded.
Hey, they had amplified music at Faulkner's house last night outside.
Oh, absolutely.
And they have amplified music at the baseball stadium. That's in the city. And we had music outdoors last year.
You did send him an invitation, right?
I did send him an invitation.
All events have bumps in them. And obviously, we thought we had things worked out with this one. We thought everything was the way it should be. It didn't work out that way, but we're going to carry on. And I think the true test of how to throw an event, you should figure out how to adapt. Although I think it would have been, if as planned, an over-the-top event. You know, I think we've been over-the-top and outlandish. Now we're probably just a little bit of over-the-top. So I think it's still going to be great. I still think people are going to talk about this for years. I believe people are going to see things here tonight that they're going to try and duplicate at their own parties because it's going to be that interesting.
Whew. I think it all is going to work out.
Oh, it's going to be fine. No one's going to know the
I know, but it would have been perfect.
I know.
But to have the band out in the Grove. But this will be just as good.
The fact that people were stopping cars to take pictures. They hadn't even seen what was going to happen yet, and they were taking pictures.
Yeah. My phone's blowing up. I just quit answering. With people calling, and the emails are just piling up. Can I come? Can I come? Can I come? I just you know, I went offline now. I'm off circuit.
I wasn't sure whether I was going to do this again. It wore me out so bad that I wasn't going to do it for a while, probably several more years. And when I when the football schedule came back and I saw A&M was coming, I said, And I called Wayne up over at the powerhouse. When he answered the phone, he said to me, I know why you're calling, because you're going to do it again. And I said, Wayne, I guess we got to do it one more time.
As soon as I started asking people if they knew who Blake Tartt was, everyone knew who Blake Tartt was. One of the coolest things I've ever heard about Blake, he filled the whole house full of sand, and it was a beach party, and it was an awesome party, but the house mother wanted to kill Blake because that sand was in the house for probably the next 10 years.
Well, I was happy when I finally got the chance to meet him because he's helped out our fraternity so much in many different ways.
He comes to Oxford, I mean, unannounced all the time. He'll be like, I'm landing in 30 minutes, meet me at the airport.
Yeah, bring some cold beer.
Bring some cold beer from when we land.
The
yeah, from the time he hits the runway,
it's a blast.
It's a blast.
I come to Oxford, matter of fact, I tell people I work in Houston and I live in Oxford. Oxford just has such a great charm to it, and it's a great place to live, walk, engage the senses, and experience life at a normal pace.
I'm the dean of the business school at Ole Miss, and I met Blake through my interaction there. And one of the things I love about Blake is he does all of the four things that we want people to do to help us. He gives money, he gives his time with the kids, he hires our kids, and he also recruits them to come to Ole Miss.
But after seeing last year's party and hearing what he has to say about it, I'm expecting big things, and I'm sure it's going to blow my expectations away again.
We heard his party last year was just incredible. I mean, everybody's been talking about it, and you can't really outdo a Blake Tartt party from what I've heard.
If Blake's going to put his name on something, he's going to blow everybody else out of the water.
I'm not surprised that he's doing this party again. You know, Blake's a promoter, and he loves to show people a good time, and he loves to entertain his friends. So, no, I'm not surprised at all. I wouldn't be surprised if he continued to do this for quite some time.
Flattered that Blake Tartt chose to invite a former professor from 30 years ago. Is that not amazing? And we're thrilled to be here and wish him and everybody else the best. Hotty toddy.
Okay, my name is Andy Neff, and I've only been in Oxford for a couple of months. And when I got my new job as the managing editor of hottytoddy.com, one of my first assignments was to contact Blake and ask him about his development plans for Oxford. I knew he was a Ole Miss grad and loves Oxford and has a place here and really interested in the future development of the city. So I talked to him, I did a story, and it went over really well. So I got an invitation to the party.
Yeah, I'm just happy to be here. I didn't make it last year and heard a lot about it, and it's blown me out of the water so far, and I'm pretty impressed.
I've been blessed with success, and now it's time for me to be significant. I hope that I can be a role model to students. Events like this teach people to give back to the community and to give back to the university. In anything that you do, you have to give back to receive. Better than I could have ever expected. It was unbelievable. It was a reunion of all my friends. The only thing I was really sad about is that my mom and dad weren't here. I have a whole stack of letters from people, and so many people have written me and said, you know, thank you for the party. We appreciated the speech and we're praying for your father. I think a lot of the Sid McKay students that came know how much I care about Ole Miss, and I think they realize I try to help them out, and I give back by trying to hire Ole Miss students, give them jobs, give them internships, and hopefully they, you know, they went away too knowing that it was all about the love for them.
Presented by Hampton Hotels, feel the Hamptonality. And in part by the new luxuriously innovative LaCrosse from Buick.
That's at Powerhouse last night. We were part of the festivities. Great party down there for about 10,000 of the close friends. And I got to get new friends.
I never did get any pictures.
You were gonna, you know what? I forgot. I took a couple last night, too.
Time that we were wild and restless out of our mind, but now I'm waking up at 6 o'clock for breakfast and get me to my work on time. We used to live now, baby, oh, just like a rock and roll song. It seemed like these days keep rolling along, rolling along, rolling along. It seems like these days we keep rolling, oh, we keep on rolling along.
Absolutely.
Do you think you can top this year's party?
Never. No way to top this year's party. But if we do another party, it will be different with a whole nother theme.